In this illustration, we'll analyze an elastic collision between three discs. Here, the figure shows two identical discs, B and C, at rest placed on a smooth horizontal table at a separation nr, where r is the radius of these discs. And another identical disc A is moving symmetrically as shown. We are required to find the value of n for which after elastic collision, disc A will rebound back. Here, in this situation, if we wish to find the value of n for which A will rebound back, we find the condition for which A will come to rest after collision. So, if the value of n will be less than that, the impulse on A will be more and it will bounce. So, if we consider A comes to rest after collision, this implies the situation would be like this. These are the two discs, B and C, on which when A will strike at this position, A was moving at a speed u, and the impulse will appear a normal reaction between these balls like this, and ball B and C will start moving in the direction of these impulses, say with the values v1 and v1, and say if this angle is theta, because we are given that the separation between the two balls is nr. So, if this angle is theta, here we can write by conservation of momentum, the initial momentum of disk A was mu. So, we can write mu is equals to final momentum in horizontal direction for both of these disks will be v1 cos theta and v1 cos theta components. So, this can be written as 2m v1 cos theta. So, this is our first equation. And by energy conservation, as collision is elastic, we can conserve energy. So, by energy conservation, we have half mu square as initial kinetic energy, and after collision, final energy is twice of half mv1 square. Here m gets cancelled out and this 2 also gets cancelled out, and solving this will give us the value of v1 is equals to u by root 2. Say this is our second equation. Then from 1 we can get the value of v1. If we substitute u by root 2, then we can see this is u is equals to twice of u by root 2 multiplied by cos theta, which implies the value of cos theta is equals to 1 by root 2, which implies the value of theta should be 45 degrees. If theta is 45 degrees, then from this triangle we can write from the above figure, we can write in this situation, this distance is 2r. So, this 2r cos 45 degree must be equals to nr by 2. This implies here we are getting the value of n is equals to 2 root 2. So, if n is equals to 2 root 2, then it implies after collision, A will come to rest, which is the point from where we started. So, if we consider A to be at rest after collision, the value of n we are getting is 2 root 2. So, if the value of n is less than 2 root 2, the value of theta will be less and the impulse imparted on the ball A will be more and it will rebound. So, here we can write ball A will rebound back if n is equals to or n is less than 2 root 2. So, that will be the final result of this problem.